Ladies, I am proud to be invited as a speaker to this WISTA conference. And you represent one of the most important and valuable networks in our industry. No doubt that we are an industry overpopulated with men. Our ambition must be to improve the balance with significantly more women in top positions. And WISTA is a key player if we are to succeed in this ambition. So I will use this opportunity to say thank you for your important work. And even more important, keep up the good work. Our industry needs you, your energy, your engagement, your competence, and your power. I have been asked today to talk about energy and logistics in the Arctic. We are all familiar with the importance of shipping, both in the World Wide Web of logistics and as a key player in securing the world's demand for energy. I will not repeat the numbers, but in short, we can say without shipping, half the world would freeze and half the world would starve. So what do we see in the future? We see a world with a growing population. A growing world needs more food, more energy, more natural resources, and more minerals. And our oceans hold the solutions to these growing demands. However, it is important to find new solutions that contribute to environmentally friendly and sustainable global growth. There are two important issues that will heavily affect us as an industry in the coming years. Also, when we talk about activities in the Arctic, and that is climate change and digitalization. These issues, in isolation and combined, will have an unprecedented impact both on how we run our ships and on how we run our companies. So, what about the Arctic? The Arctic is a place of increased interest, increased activity, and increased strategic value. We see increased activity within shipping activities, increased extraction of energy, and increased tourism and cruise. But we are also witnessing deeply concerning development. Consequences of global warming are more dramatic in the Arctic than in any other parts of the world. During the last 30 years, 2/3 of the summer ice has disappeared. 2/3 of the summer sea ice has disappeared. Climate change and global warming will require global solutions. It should be clear to everyone that to reach ambitious Paris Agreement goals, we must do more to reduce the CO2 footprint, also from the shipping industry and from the activities in the Arctic. We need ambitious international regulation. That is the only way that we really can contribute towards combating climate change. So we are a strong supporter for the ambitious IMO reducing strategy, reducing the CO2 emissions from our industry by 50% by 2050. New regulations in this field represent opportunities for the maritime industry to develop new technology based on hybrid solutions, alternative fuels, new design, improved operations, or other solutions to reduce emissions. Given this concerning backdrop of melting sea ice, we should be cautious, responsible, knowledge-based, and protective in our approach to activities in this vast and vulnerable area. However, we must remember that there have been people and activities in certain parts of the Arctic for a very long time. 4 billion peoples live in the Arctic areas, and the Arctic economy constitutes $230 billion, the size of Finland's or Portugal's economy. The Arctic represents vast opportunities for economic growth, science, research, innovation, and development. Our point is that activities in the Arctic must be supported by a holistic approach based on the safekeeping of people and equipment, and even more important, environment protection. Part of the Arctic offers tremendous challenges. Cold climate, extreme weather, darkness, vast distances, ice and icing conditions, and lack of infrastructure. With this in mind, it is important for us as a shipping industry to focus on investments to reduce the risks. We need investments in developing of robust infrastructure. We need global regulations and international standards. The IMO's Polar Code is important to secure international standard for all shipping activities in this area. We need improved weather forecasts and sea ice monitoring. We need to improve the communication, and we need to improve also the search and rescue capacity. I would particularly point out the need to address preparedness. Search and rescue capacity in these areas is of crucial importance for all activities going on. The second trend that heavily will influence us as an industry going forward is the development of digitalization. New technologies develop fast. What many of us today take for granted didn't exist 10 years ago. What lies ahead is hard to predict, but there's no doubt that the processes employing digitalization and autonomous technology will pick up speed dramatically. Digitalization will shape the shipping, will change shipping fundamentally with more autonomous operations, new business models, new trade patterns, and at the same time, increased connectivity will mean increased vulnerability. This requires new competencies and new regulations for our industry. And as we speak, Yara and Kongsberg are developing the world's first emission-free and fully autonomous vessel to go into traffic in the southern part of Norway. New technologies will certainly also be important for the future activities in the high north. So given these trends and developments within the climate and within the digitalization, paired with our long polar traditions, I believe that the maritime sector and our industry are capable of approaching future opportunities in the Arctic in a responsible manner. Managing the global oceans requires the involvement of all stakeholders, especially the private sector. All ocean industries have a responsibility to help maintain the health and productivity of the marine environment. And we need new ideas. We have to lean forward and we have to lead the way to a sustainable future. In this process, we need you, the WISTA community, to help shape the future for our industry. Congratulations with a great conference. And all the best in your important work. Thank you.